So here we are, ready to go racing for one final time this year. Another season of victories, controversies and rivalries lies in our wake. And just one challenge remains here in the United Arab Emirates on a circuit that made its spectacular debut back in 2009. Welcome to the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix. The drivers will be racing here at the Yas Marina circuit through 21 corners and a lap distance of just over 3.4 miles. There are a few opportunities to pass, with long straights and DRS zones in two places, turns 8 and turn 11. Plenty of close racing then, plenty of speed, and I hope plenty of drama to be found in the laps ahead. Anthony Davidson is with me one last time this year as we bid a fond farewell to another great season of Formula One.
It's been another great year of racing, but let's not look back just yet. We've still got one more Grand Prix ahead of us. Some of these drivers don't know if they'll be in the sport next year or how competitive their car might be even if they are. So this is a race where every driver should be striving to make the most of it.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position with Charles Leclerc alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Hamilton, Vettel, Carlos Sainz, and Ricciardo, Perez, Ocon, Stroll, and Daniel Kvyat. Giovinazzi, Verstappen, Kimi Raikkonen, the rookie, Albon. They've taken a grid penalty. Magnussen, George Russell, and Lando Norris. Latifi, Gasly, Grosjean, and Nick De Vries. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
We came close to scoring points last race. Let's make it happen today. Clutch bite is good, gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres and brakes throughout the lap. Expected. No rain expected for the time being. out the start, we can still get a good result here. Will be enabled this lap. You can use it when within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Monitoring somewhere on the ICE, be aware that we will start to see a loss of power. Caution, caution. Okay, clear. We advise moving to mix 2, fuel to mix 2. Some time to the car behind. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. Okay, gap ahead is 1.9 seconds. Front is a second a lap faster, 1 second. more stop today. One stop left in our strategy. For the mediums, car behind on the medium tyre. Is coming in for his stop. Green flag. going to be able to run in this engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix two soon. We're leading our teammate by 14.6 seconds. For the mediums, car behind on the medium tyre. We'll be right back. 7, you've taken P11. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. Gap to teammate behind is 18.4 seconds. Release. Look after these tires now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Burned off our excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down. Gap behind is 15.1 seconds. To fit the mediums, car ahead, now running medium tires. Nick in the pits. behind has come in. They're now on the soft tyre, softs on the car behind. To stay with him, he might make a mistake. We could still regain the position. Five laps of fuel remaining. We're leading our teammate by 26.2 seconds. There's three laps of fuel remaining. You have P13, P13, Norris ahead. Our gap to the car in front is 1.5 seconds. They're on old softs. Magnussen is behind you. Our gap behind is 5.8 seconds. They're on old mediums. The gap to the leader is 40.7 seconds. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Just three laps to go now. Three laps. Managing your tyres. Manage your tyres. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Gap to teammate behind is 28.0 seconds. That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
And so the celebrations begin, and well-earned they are indeed. It may have looked simple at times, but as any racing driver can tell you, competing at this level, at the very top, is anything but simple. There's no catching them now then. We have a new World Drivers' Champion. Victory today then, but bittersweet emotions, I'm sure, as the championship slips through their fingers. Even so, what a fantastic final race of the season this was. Talk to me, what do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes. Valtteri Bottas passes his rival to take over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
That's got to be the flying fin. Wait, how many flying fins have we had now? Anyway, I'm talking about Bottas this time. Just great raw speed and a good job in traffic as well.
It's another clear win for Mercedes as they manage to secure the Constructors' title. An incredible performance for the whole team. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing.